welcome to Neutral Side Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Inside handoff. He's taken down at the 36. And the delayed handoff works for a big gain.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
He's on the run. And they push him out around the 47-yard line.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Carries the ball for a nice game.
That makes it 76.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over the sideline after the series, make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line. He looks pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
Fires incomplete. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 41-yard line. Are complete to the halfback over the middle, and he is drilled at the 29. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
And he's tackled around the 31-yard line. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. He gets hit out of bounds, right around the 30. And a quick throw. And they make the stop at about the 7-yard line. He's on the run. Play 13 of the current drive.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that.
Fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Utah is looking to go up by three. It's up, and he's got it. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Throws a bullet. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 26. Wants to throw outside. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. Tackle at about the 45.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. He's tackled around the 28-yard line. From the 28-yard line, it's second down. It's complete. Down right around the 18-yard line. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Tried to fool him by running the same play again.
Well, fooled no one there, Brad.
From the 18-yard line, second down. Off play action. Now he's on the move. He flings it. Play action pass. Touchdown.
Great effort by the wide receiver. And not to take anything away from the quarterback, but the wide receiver made this play.
He makes the PAT. A 10-play, 74-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard. The score now, 7-3. Colorado is ready to kick it away. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 26-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Fires out to his receiver. And he's taken down around the 40-yard line.
wants it all. Going deep.
That close to being intercepted.
So it's second and 10.
Ball on the 40-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 50-yard line. Up the middle for a nice game.
Everybody, because it looks like they came ready to play today. 7-3, Buffalo.
And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two.
Slings it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 14-yard line.
Big opening. Touchdown, Utah.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. And he adds the extra point. A seven-play, 74-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Boy, this has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield.
This defensive end just showed us why he's much more than just a pass rusher.
Second down and 12. Ball on their own 23. Catches it, and that's all.
Any offense is predicated on being able to move efficiently like this.
Here's the give. Nice run there as they work the outside.
He kept churning his legs, trying to grind out those last few feet, but the defense just held him.
He got hit hard. Not a bad return. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Utah holds a field goal lead. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Five wide. And he's immediately tackled. Complete. He's got room.
He's taken down around the 30-yard line. He's pushed out of bounds at the 14. Handoff inside, and they got him for a loss. From the 15-yard line, second down. He's got it with room to run, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 10-yard line. The throw caught, touchdown. Converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, you know the offense would like to generate more than they did on their last possession. Like the defense was in man coverage there, fellas, and that's why they stopped that screen.
Yeah, and when the secondary isn't dropping back into zone, it makes it difficult to have success with that kind of screen play.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Tackles him hard at the 38. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Rifles it right side. And he's tackled at the 19-yard line.
This is a great pitch and catch combination, and they hook up here for a big-time game.
He'll get the call again. And they hit him in the backfield. From the 21-yard line, second down. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five-wide outlook. And they make the stop at the 13.
Sense the energy coming from the sidelines right now. They know how important it is to pick up first downs. And the coaches right now are showing the excitement that they have and yelling out the next play for the offense. But clearly, the offensive coordinator very happy about the execution of the last play.
And they get the sack.
Yeah.
steps out
at about the 5-yard line.
It's fourth down.
This should be an easy field goal.
And they can make this a one possession game with this kick right here.
Kicks away.
And it sails through the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. Fielded at the 4. Tackle at the 21-yard line.
The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Tackle around the 26-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. We've played a half. The Utes lead 17-10.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Nobody's been able to run the football in the first half. Neither ground game really got anything going. And you know, an offensive line, David, has to work in unison. They have to be like the Rockettes. They have to be in perfect step. And these guys, they were dancing to their own tune.
It's the biggest Rockettes I've ever seen. Goodness gracious.
Ugliest ones,
yeah,
too.
Yeah. Well, the big fat boys do have to work together. The big uglies, and they got to step together. But and you can't allow guys to run through clear. And you see tackles for a loss, especially in the run game when it's this unsuccessful in the first half. You know they're not all working together. And there's too many guys that are getting penetration and making plays. So they got to get it shored up. Run blocking is the thing they like to do the best. They like to get their big meat hooks on you, grab you, and hold you. And, you know, to be honest, they got to do a better job of it if they want to get some successful running game going in the second half.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He'll return it from the 3. Gets to about the 24-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And down he goes, right at the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line, first down. Gets it. He's in space. He's tackled at the 49. From the 49-yard line. First down. Gets to about the 47-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
That was the junior linebacker who'll get credit with the tackle there.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Tackled after a decent pickup. Hi, guys, incomplete. Brought down, nothing doing. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Here's an opening. And he carries the ball for a nice game. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. This is the 9th play of this drive. Gets out to around the 12. First and 10. Ball on the 12. Some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. Just throws this one away. And here's another 3rd down.
The offensive line and the receivers made a concerted effort to get into the end zone.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he hits the PAT. The Buffalo's running back sidelined earlier with that injury. Right now, though, it looks like he's warming up and trying to get back in the ballgame. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 22-yard line. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. They come out in a 5-wide set. He's scrambling. They line up at the 14. It's 2nd down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Locked down at about the 33-yard line.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Quick throw. He's taken down around the 46-yard line. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
They come out on an empty backfield. Up the middle for a nice game. With room to work. They'll bring him down around the 39-yard line. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. That makes it 2nd and 6. This is the 8th play of this drive. Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's taken down at the 24-yard line. Nice play to set up first and goal. He fights forward to about the 7. About the 5-yard line. And he's tackled at the 2-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, good game here, 17-17. Tied up, and we head to the all-important fourth quarter. It's up, and he got it. And so they take the lead with that field goal.
Big-time kick late in the game. That was a clutch kick to put them up on top.
Utah gets set to kick this one away. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, a close game. They're behind here in the fourth quarter, but they've got a chance to take the lead. Nice run, and he's brought down. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. His way to the 46-yard line. And he snags that one. And they make the stop at the 40-yard line.
Illegal touching. Offense.
Penalty will move them back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
So it's second down and 15 after the penalty. Tackle made around the 48-yard line. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
From the 40-yard line, it's first down. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. Makes it out to about the 30. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. He's at the 20. Makes it out to about the 13. This is the 8th play of the drive. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Touchdown!
He has three scoring tosses in the game now.
The one thing this quarterback does a nice job of is taking what the defense gives him. He's always looking for the open target.
Let me tell you, life can be easier when you've got kids who can make catches like that. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. At the 30. And he just got stood up right there. The Utes were really mistaken if they looked at this game as a gimmick.
Well, they've been in a dogfight the entire ball game. Let's see what they can do with this final drive. They still have time here to be able to pull out and try to get a win.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Knocked out of bounds at the 33. Just over 2 minutes in the game. He's got it with room to run. And down he goes at about the 49. That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. He heaves it deep. The 10. He gets out to about the 8.
That brings up second and 1.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. There's a laser across the middle. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. And he adds the extra point. Utah is lining up to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Colorado's ranking, that doesn't mean anything right now.
No, they've not played up to their expectations at all, but they have the football here late in the game. They're very fortunate to still have a chance to maybe win it because they've not looked like themselves.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. 5 wide. He's going to go for the home run. And he's hit immediately.
Well, that's a big play by the offense. And I got to tell you, as a defense coordinator, you're blitzing and you're taking some chances. And it's one thing to blitz and to get to the quarterback and everybody high-fives and gets excited. But if you blitz and you don't get home, as they say, which means hitting the quarterback, you're leaving your defensive backs one-on-one in coverage. And if you don't get to that quarterback and you're facing a talented quarterback like this man right here, you're going to pay for it.
They come out in a 5-wide set. Complete. He's got room. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. We have less than a minute to go. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. We've got second and goal. Ball on the 8-yard line. Touchdown! And that gives them the lead. He makes the PAT. Colorado to kick. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line.
Man, hang on to your hats, folks, because both these offenses are in gear right now.
Well, the way these guys are executing right now, it could come down to just which defense can come up with one stop.
Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership.
Needed that play, and he dropped it. From their own 28-yard line. Second down. Under a minute left. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideout. Flips it middle to the running back.
Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game.
They're all tied in on the line here on fourth and short. He's pushed out of bounds at the 44. From their own 44-yard line. First down.
Into that quickly.
He's tackled at the 49-yard line.
Utah is going to have to use their second time out of the half.
He lets it fly. Makes the catch, and look out. They've done it. I can't believe it. Trying to go up by three. They'll kick the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point.
Well, folks, do you think we can see another Cal Stanford? They need to return this all the way to win it.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This has been a great game, and it all comes down to this. Who can prevail, the offense or the defense? We're about to find out who's going to win it in this drive.
This one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 34-31, Utes. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action of this one?
This is just a tough loss to take. Colorado has got to be heartbroken to lose such a close game as this one was. They came in as huge underdogs, but they played their hearts out and almost came away with the big upset.
that brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.